Welcome back to our intermediate financial accounting class. Over the last few segments, we've been talking about the balance sheet, what it is, why it's important, what its limitations are, and how it should look. In our last segment specifically, we started to build a balance sheet. We had a lot of fun putting together the current asset section and talking about the different segments of the asset general category and how we can break that down to provide our investors more information. Now that we've got that current asset section done, it's time to move on to long-term investments. Now remember, long-term investments are assets that we've purchased not to use, but to hold and then sell later, hopefully at a nice profit. Let's take a look at our raw data tab and see if we can find the two long-term investments that this company uses. They may not jump out to you immediately, but here they are. One is the expansion fund, right here. An expansion fund means that we're saving up for some kind of expansion. We're going to build a new plant, we're going to extend a plant, we're going to move into a new country or into a new market. We're saving up to grow the business. Well, because we're not going to use those assets for anything but the expansion, then it gets classified as a long-term investment. Because I'm not using it, and it's certainly not current, so it goes in that long-term investment category. The other one is down here. It's loans to other businesses. I have loaned money to somebody else, a subsidiary, a colleague business, somebody that I have some synergy with for my sales, or just as an investment in general. But if I've loaned money to them, then they have to pay me back. It's kind of a long-term accounts receivable. But because it's long-term, it can't go with the accounts receivables, but it's not a physical asset, so it becomes a long-term investment. I expect to get my money back, and some interest. So those are our two long-term investment accounts, and again, I'm marking these in purple as we use them. So let's go ahead to our balance sheet and we'll type these in. We've got our expansion fund. And we have our loans to other businesses. Okay. And again, I'm going to link these. So expansion fund, $60,000. Loans to other businesses, $80,000. And if I highlight both of those, and it's kind of hard to see because there's a line down here, that underline, but that little black box is still there. And when I put my cursor over it, I get the plus. And I drag across, and there's my value. And you can see, in this year too, I didn't add anything to these investments. They haven't really grown. They're just the same as they were before. Next, we're looking for long-term assets. And again, let's go back to our raw data tab. And let's look for long-term assets. Now again, you typically have a lot of flexibility with the order that you use when you build your balance sheet. Current assets, again, we put them in order of liquidity based on our best judgment. Long-term investments, really no rule there. Sometimes you'll see them in order of liquidity, sometimes alphabetically. With our PP&E, instead of liquidity or alphabetical, what we usually see is the non-depreciable first, which is basically just land, and then everything that is depreciable next. So let's find our land account first, if we've got one. Oh, and there it is. So let's go to our balance sheet. We'll put land in because land doesn't depreciate. Next, we're going to put in our depreciable assets, and there are two of them. One of them is my building, and one of them is equipment. So let's go to our balance sheet, and we'll put in our building first, and then our equipment. And let's go ahead and link those in. Building, equipment. The last is our accumulated depreciation, and you'll see this different ways depending on usually the age of the business, the size of the accounting department, whether they're reporting to the SEC. Usually younger, smaller businesses will have an accumulated depreciation for each asset that is being depreciated, and those that are bigger, they're reporting to the SEC, they usually just have one accumulated depreciation line. And that's what we're going to do for this one. We just have the one line. Now, again, accumulated depreciation, like allowance for bad debt, is a contra asset. So instead of putting it as a positive number, since it's got a credit balance and being listed with all these debits, it's going to have a negative. You can do equals a negative, or you can just do a negative. Either way, Excel will bring it in. So accumulated depreciation right up here, 240. And we'll drag that across. And let's go back and highlight those. They've been used. And that's going to give us now our total PP&E, 700,000 this year, 360,000 the year before. So we have grown substantially in this current year. Our last section is going to be our intangible assets section, and we really only have one asset left. So let's go back to our raw data tab. It's right here. It's our patents that we have purchased. So these are intangible assets. You can't touch a patent. I mean, you can touch the piece of paper, but the actual patent itself, the protection that it provides, you can't touch it. You can't use it as a physical asset, but it has a lot of value as an intangible asset. It protects my business and allows me to earn more money than I would be able to without that patent. So we get to record at least part of the value of that. So patent, and you'll notice here I don't have a total intangible assets line like I have for these others, total PP&E, total long-term investments, total current assets, because there's only the one. So it really doesn't make any sense. Last thing we need to wrap this up and put it in good form is a total assets line. So right down here in C26, I'm going to add current assets plus long-term investments plus total PP&E plus, it's hard to see that, but I'm going to add in that patent as well. And if I make this row a little bit bigger, you should be able to see that a little bit better. There we go. So that's one option. You can see I've got all those little plus signs in there. The other option is to use your sum command, and then you just use commas. And those are total assets in the current year, year two, and last year, year one. And you can see that this company has grown substantially over this last year, over $300,000 in growth. That's pretty good. Probably. Depends on the industry and the history of the company. But chances are, it's pretty good growth. We're going to go ahead and stop there. When we come back, we'll start talking about the liabilities and the equity section of our balance sheet. I'll see you then.